If n is an integer such that 1nn352 is a 6-digit number exactly divisible by 24, what will be the sum of possible values of n? So the number is exactly divisible by 24. So let me split 24 in terms of co-primes first, which is 8 and 3. So the number should be divisible by both 8 and 3, then it will be divisible by 24. What's divisibility rule of 8? Last 3 digits should be divisible. Now check the last 3 digits. 352. Yes, that satisfies the condition. 352 is exactly divisible by 8. So the condition of 8 satisfied. Now let's check the condition of 3. What's the condition of 3? Sum of digits of the number should be divisible by 3. Sum of digits of the number should be divisible by 3. So let's add the digits. 1 plus n plus n plus 3 plus 5 plus 2. This particular thing should be divisible by 3. So what is the sum we get? 3 plus 5 is 8. 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 1, 11 plus 2n. 11 plus 2n should be divisible by 3. So which multiple of 3 is so close to 11? It's 11 plus. So let's check the multiples which is more than 11. That means in case 1, one case, I can take the sum should be equals to 15, which is more than 11 and a multiple of 3. Or else the sum can be even equals to the next multiple, which is 18. Or the sum can be even equals to the next multiple 21. The sum can be even equals to 24. Like this, again, the sum can be even equals to 27. There are a lot of possibilities. So let's check. First, if I equate the sum to 15, 11 plus 2n, this sum should be equals to 15. Then only this will be divisible by 3. So 11 plus 2n should be equals to 15. That implies 2n will be equal to 4. So n is equals to 2. So I got a number n as 2. So this is possible case. So n is equals to 2 is possible. What will happen if I consider sum as 18? 11 plus 2n is equals to 18. So n will be nothing but here 18 minus 11 means it is going to give me 7 here. So n will be in terms of decimal. I can't consider this. And a small logic is when 11 is an odd number, if you subtract from an even number, you will get odd itself. If you get odd and if you divide it by 2, you will get in terms of decimals. That's why there is no necessary of taking evens, means 18, 24 is not necessary because you will definitely get your answer in terms of decimals. So this is not going to happen. So let's leave this case and let's equate to 21 now. So 11 plus 2n is equals to 21. That implies 2n is equals to 10. So n 5 is also possible. So n is 5. This is also possible. And similarly, I'll go with 27. So 11 plus 2n is equals to 27. That implies 2n is equals to 16. So n value is equals to 8. So 8 is also possible. The next one is going to be 30 multiple. This is again an even number, no necessary to consider. Now the next sum can be 33 also. But 11 difference 33 is going to give us 22. 22 means n value will become 11. Again, it's a double digit number, so we won't consider it. So what are the possible values? 2 is possible, 5 is possible, and 8 is possible. So what's our question? Find the sum of this possible value. So what is the sum? 2 plus 5 is 7. 7 plus 8 is nothing but 15. So what's my answer for this question? Option D, 15. So answer for this question is 15. X plus 10 percentage of 240 is 60 percentage more than X percentage of 180. Then 15 percentage of X plus 20 is what percentage less than 25 percentage of X? So let's try to calculate first value of X by using this particular statement given in the question. So what they said, X plus 10 percentage of 240 is 60% more than X percentage of 180. That means X percentage of 180 plus 60% of that. So 60% is of again X percentage of 180. So what we can do is instead of considering this two times, we can actually consider it as 160% is of X percentage of 180. 160% is of X percentage of 180 because this would be 100% and again 60% would be added. So this should be equals to X plus 10 percentage of 240. So let's try to identify value of X. For that, we will write percentage in terms of fractions. So I can say here X plus 10 divided by 100 into 240 should be equals to 160 divided by 100 into X percentage. Again, X by 100 into 180. So let's try to cancel. 100 and 100 will get canceled. I can eliminate these zeros and I can eliminate this zero and this zero too. I will cancel it with 4 first. 46 and 4 fours here, 6 ones and 6 threes here. So what else is left? With 2 I can cancel, 5. Now this is left. So let me send 5 this side. So what it will give us, 5x plus 50 is equals to, how much is left here? 2 into 3 is 6x. That implies x value is equals to 50. So we got our value of x. X is 50. Now what's our question? 15% of x plus 20. 15% of x plus 20 is how much? 15% of x is 50. 50 plus 20 means 70. So 15% of 70. 15% of 70 is nothing but 10.5. So 15% of x plus 20 is what percentage less than 25% of x? So how much is this? 25% of x. X is 50. So what is 25% of 50? It is 12.5. So they're asking 10.5 is how much less than 12.5. So percentage less will be equals to the difference between them is how much? 12.5 minus 10.5 divided by, with what I'm comparing? I'm comparing with 12.5. So 12.5 should be in the base into 100. So this is going to give us 2 divided by 12.5 into 100. So let's just eliminate it. With 25, I'm cancelling 4 here, 0.5 here. So again, 8 divided by 0.5 is nothing but 16%. So how much is the percentage? 16%, it is less. So what's my answer for this question? Option C. A man has to travel 50 kilometers in 2 hours. 50 kilometers in 2 hours. He covered 20 kilometers in 1 hour. He covered 20 kilometers in 1 hour and then had to stop for 10 minutes for refueling. By what factor should he increase his speed with reference to that during the first hour so as to be able to complete the journey as per the schedule? So that's what they ask us. We need to identify what is the factor he should increase the speed. Now, first observe, first he traveled 20 kilometers in 1 hour. That is what he traveled. So first, in the initial, first he traveled 20 kilometers. That means distance is equals to 20 kilometers. And the time taken by him is 1 hour. That means speed will be equals to distance divided by time. This is kilometer and this is hour itself. So we can take 20 divided by 1, which is 20 kilometer per hour. So initially, in the starting 1 hour, he went with a speed of 20 kilometer per hour. Now, second, how much he should increase it? First of all, let's identify what is the speed he should maintain. So 20 kilometers is done, completed. Total 50 kilometers. 20 kilometers is completed. That means what is the left distance? Distance left will be equals to 30 kilometers. 30 kilometers. Now, this particular distance should be covered in 2 hours. Generally, 50 kilometers should be covered in 2 hours. Already 1 hour is completed here. Okay, and 10 minutes he is going to stop. So how much time is left? Total 2 hours. 1 hour is completed. That means 1 hour is actually left. In that 1 hour also, he is going to stop for 10 minutes. That means how much time is left? Left time will be nothing but 50 minutes here. Just 50 minutes is left. So I'm going to write this minutes in terms of hour because this is in terms of kilometers. So I can say it as 50 divided by 60 hours, which is nothing but 5 by 6 hours. Now, he needs to cover 30 kilometers in 50 divided by 60 hours, right? 50 divided by 6, nothing but 5 by 6 hours. Now, what will be the speed he needs to maintain? Speed will be distance divided by time. The distance here is 30 divided by time he should complete is 5 by 6. So 5 by 6, that implies 30 into 6 by 5 it will become when it comes to the top. So 5 ones and 5 six. So how much speed he should maintain? 36 kilometers per hour. If he maintain for this 50 minutes, he will complete this 30 kilometers. That means this 50 kilometers will be done in 2 hours as planned. Okay, now what's our question? What is the factor increase we should identify? They did not ask us what is the new speed. They're asking us how much is the factor increase. So to identify increase in factor, so increase in factor is always calculated as, increase in factor is always calculated as new speed divided by, you can say initial speed or old speed, divided by old speed or initial speed, whatever he is maintaining. Initial speed, this is going to give us the factor. So what is the new speed he should maintain? 36 divided by what is his initial speed or old speed? 20. Before, to cover this 20 kilometers, now we need to identify how much he should increase on this. Than the first hour, how much he should increase? So on what you should increase on 20, so 36 divided by 20 is going to give us. So 36 divided by 20 is nothing but 1.8. So how much factor he should increase? 1.8. So my answer is option B. If they ask you what is the speed, it will be 36 kilometer per hour. But they haven't asked you what is the speed. They're asking what is the factor he should increase with respect to this first 1 hour. So how much he should maintain now divided by what is the speed he maintained in the first hour. So 36 divided by 20 means 1.8 is the factor. Option B. The variation in temperatures throughout the day in a desert town was studied on the basis of the record of minimum and maximum temperatures, which were 8 and 36 degrees centigrade respectively. What is the standard deviation in degrees centigrade? So we should identify standard deviation. So standard deviation S will be equals to root of sigma X I minus mu whole square divided by N. So this is the formula of standard deviation, where mu is nothing but the mean. Okay, mu is called the mean. Mu defines mean here. Mean means nothing but average. So you can directly do minimum plus maximum divided by 2. So 8 plus 36 divided by 2. Which is nothing but 22. So mu stands here 22. And N is number of observations. How many observations are done here? Only 2 observations are done. So N value is equals to 2. And Xi is nothing but each value of the temperature. That means first case 36 will come. And second case 8 will come. So how do we apply this is? It will come like root of first. First case Xi will be 36. And then you can take 8. So 36 minus mu value is 22 whole square. Sigma, this is so addition plus the next one. Next one is 8. So 8 minus 22 whole square. If any other, you should even add it also. Plus the number will come divided by how many observations? N 2. So what would be the answer? It will be 36 minus 22 is 14 square plus here also 14 minus 14 square is also 14 square itself, right? Divided by 2. Now I can say it as 2 into 14 square. 14 square plus 14 square is 2 into 14 square divided by 2. Now this 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Square and root will get cancelled. So what is left? 14. So what is the standard deviation? It's nothing but option C, 14. So this is the formula that we are going to use. So the answer for this question is option C. What is the mean proportion between the mean proportions of 2 by 7 and 32 divided by 343 and 2 and 1 divided by 5000? So first let's identify what is mean proportions of these numbers. Then we will identify again the mean proportion for them. So what is mean proportion? Mean proportion is nothing but value of B and it will be calculated as root of AC, where A is the first proportion and C is the third proportion. That means, for example, if you want to identify mean proportion for this, so mean proportion will be equals to root of first proportion here is 2 by 7 into third proportion here is 32 divided by 343. So this will give us root of 2 into 32 is 64 divided by 7 into 343 is actually 7 cube. So I can say it as 64 is 8 square divided by 7 into 7 cube means 7 to the power of 4. Now if I remove the square, so what happens here? This 2 will go and here 2 will be left because 4 is there. So 8 divided by 7 square means 49. So the mean proportion of these numbers will be 8 divided by 49. Similarly, let's apply the mean proportion for this. So what would be the mean proportion here? 2 into 1 divided by 5,000. 1 divided by 5,000. So 2 ones. And here 2,500 times. So root of 1 divided by 2,500 is how much? Root of 2,500 is 50. So 1 divided by 50. So the mean proportion here is 1 by 50. Now your question is, what is mean proportions of these mean proportions? That means you should again apply mean proportion for this two. So let's find. So what will be the mean proportion of these mean proportions? It will be root of 8 by 49 into 1 by 50. So what would be the answer? Let me try to cancel here. So I'm going to cancel with 2, 2 fours and 25s here. So this can be written as 4 is 2 square divided by 49 is 7 square into 25 is 5 square. So when I remove root, this all squares will go. So what was left? 2 divided by 35. So what is the mean proportion of these mean proportions? It's 2 divided by 35 means option D. So the answer for this question is option D. Thank you for watching the video till the end. If you liked the video, do not forget to press the like button. Also, join our social media platforms like Telegram group, Instagram page, and WhatsApp group. Links for all of this are in the description box. Thank you.